Wow, sounds like we got a storm kicking up here. It is July 5th, 2011. Here I have, I don't know, these are, I think, I hope, various types of peppers, which I just germinated from seeds, from peppers that I cooked. Remember, don't have any cream on your hands when you touch seeds, or they won't germinate. And this is a rose bush that, no, this was an orange tree that died. So I think I have some more peppers growing in there. And I put some melon seeds in there and they've sprouted. Here's another pepper. I have succulent plants and cacti out here. Very dramatic weather. The weather is very, 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 very changeable in Paris, France. The wind shifts directions. It was sunny and bright, you know, 15 minutes ago, although it's evening time now. It's nighttime. It's going on 10 p.m. See how bright it is? I wouldn't mind some rain, although the drought seems to have ended around here. Lots and lots and lots of major public works here. There's a river that runs under this street. It's called the Croult, C-R-O-U-L-T. And they're doing this like big project over here with like a rainwater runoff thing and collecting the water, so the street cleaning trucks and fire trucks and stuff, I guess, can get water. Although pumper trucks don't usually carry water. I know they do exist here because there are some places that there's no hookup nearby. Even in the city sometimes, you'd be surprised. There's an archaeological dig open in Saint-Denis, right in the center of town, and we hope to go see it soon. I'll try to get you some clips. We have these here all the time because this is an ancient city. And it goes back to, it's older than Paris. It was the capital of France before Paris. This was France, actually. Saint-Denis, the name of Saint-Denis used to be Pays de France, country of France. And they had some lands like out in Champagne, if I understand correctly. So it's kind of ominous, but it's nice to feel the weather cooling down. See how ugly this is not a balcony. These are stores out here. And, that smells like rain. Ooh. The problem with this is, during the hot weather, the stones really heat up during the day. So we have to really close the shutters during the day, especially up front here. Otherwise, we just fry in here. Air conditioning is not very much found in France, nor are fans, but it's usually, in Paris, there's usually When the weather's normal, there's usually a heat wave in the beginning of May, and then it's okay until about, it could start up late June, early July. Around then. Then we get this intense heat. But when all goes well, it tends to break around August 15th. No guarantee, and there will still be hot spells going through September. But by late September, autumn weather really starts. And my first visit here was one of the last weeks of September, and it was very hot, and all the trees were green when I got here, and by the end of the week, it was quite cool, and the trees had started to change, and it's actually a very good way to get sick, and I did. Although the air is quite dirty here. And many visitors do get sick when they come here. They get rhinosinusitis, bronchitis, you know. A lot of people give in to the temptation to smoke here because it's still very much a smoking culture. And we do produce most of our own cigarettes right here in France. I didn't know that until I went down south a couple of years ago. I also went last year, but last year I wasn't in the tobacco region. Yeah, I think it's going to rain. Now see, this is sort of like really dangerous storm weather when it's been so hot all day I'm from Ohio, so I'm this tornado person. I know about this sort of thing. We had a couple of tornadoes. I used to tell people here about tornadoes, and they thought I was crazy. But the day after Christmas in 1999, I woke up to this tremendous racket. It sounded like a train roaring outside. And I looked out the window, and there was this orange sky with these, like, bowl-shaped clouds, you know. And I had seen those in Ohio. And I yelled at my husband, get up, you know, we have to get ready. We have to open the windows and close the shutters halfway and stuff. And he was like, take it easy. I was like, no, this is a tornado. Look at that over there. I see a funnel cloud forming. And I was right. And we lost 300 million trees in France. That day, there was loss of life. People went out and moved their cars, and you know, trees fell on them and stuff. And a lot of the parks are still closed. You can't walk in them because, even all these years later, they have not quite finished cutting down the damaged trees, and it's too dangerous to let people walk in there. And it took about 10 years for everybody to get their you know, insurance claims sorted out, and the country was quite devastated. There was like one tornado that went across the north of France and another one that went across the south of France, plus violent storms. And I watched from the large bedroom window, and I was watching like the neighbor's antenna on their roof being ripped off, you know, heavy terracotta tiles going flying off their roofs. You know, It was really impressive. And I've also talked to them about earthquakes, and they're like, yeah, we don't get those here. And I said, you know, that's not true. They have them over in Strasbourg, in Alsace, which is France now. And sure enough, earlier this year, we had a pretty big one out in Brittany between Rennes and Vannes, which is where my family is. And it was about 4.2 on the Richter scale, if I remember correctly, and it was quite shallow. It was 2 kilometers only. And since I'm dead to my French family and have been for over a year, I don't know what they heard about it out there, or if they were aware of it, or if they felt it, you know. I don't really care. I'm kind of better off not dealing with them anymore. They got mad at me because I had a lot of problems with my spouse last year, and I actually filed some police reports on him. And they consider this tremendous disloyalty, but, you know, if it's like physical violence, you know, I'm not tolerating that, you know. I actually had a psychiatrist last year laugh at me when I complained about it and say, oh, surely you provoked him. And my alcoholism specialist, who I've been seeing off and on for years to help me stay on the straight and narrow, laughed at me also. And she knows him. She knows him. And she's treated him too. He hasn't had a drink in about 8 or 9 years, I think. And she said, you need to be hospitalized. And I said, oh, okay. And she said, you are going to a mental hospital, and you're going to be locked up, and you're not going to be able to get out. Now, this is a doctor who I have known for years. You know, that's not even legal in France. I can't get my husband locked up. He can't get me locked up. I'm not allowed to know about his medical treatment. He's not allowed to know about mine. When I was really sick about 3 years ago, I didn't tell him because I didn't have to. I didn't tell anybody until about 2 years after how sick I had been. Because you don't have to here. It's privacy. It's between you and your doctor. And your doctor cannot even talk to another doctor over here. You have to give specific consent. And it's a pretty tight ship. But as far as domestic abuse goes, it's very, very bad. There's really no help for a married woman here with no marriage contract, who has no child, and whose husband works. You know, there's no shelter. There's none for me anywhere in France, they told me last year. Alright, so there's the storm. And some more of my private stuff that I chat about, but I've always been an open book. And I hope you find it informative. Because, you know, if you're thinking of moving to another country for marriage or whatever, you had better find out everything, all of the implications, you know. It would not have been that hard for me to get a marriage contract. Yeah, it would have been more money. I would have had to go to a notaire. My husband didn't want one, and his motives were very good. You know, he felt like, you know, we both contributed pretty much financially equally to, you know, buying this place and setting up our lives together, and everything was just going to be 50-50. And I don't really recommend it, because if one partner has business problems, the other partner is thus fully liable. You know, with the marriage contract, you can keep the finances separate, legal responsibilities separate, and all of that. So you really need to get some good advice, and it's not cheap. I do give advice via my website, cutecatfaith.com, and people are just horrified when they see that I charge 200 euros for 25 minutes of consultation. That's just a basic thumbnail fee, but I lose half of that. It's declared. I lose half of that to taxes and charges, so it drops down to 100 real quickly, and that includes hours and hours and hours of follow-up, you know, in writing and everything. And I've heard from some people who were going to hire me, and they didn't, and there are some very bad consequences now. I know of one who's here in France who is in a lot of trouble. All right, so on all of these gloomy, stormy notes, be well. Bye-bye.